Hi, this is Dr. Graves with the CSUN Geography Department and geographyplanet.org. This is a quick video tutorial that will demonstrate to students one of the advanced uses of pivot tables. For this time, we'll be working with some census data that is arranged largely in vertical columns, and we want to convert that to horizontal columns so that it might be used in GIS applications or perhaps just for a better visual display of the data. So what you see in front of you is data about ethnicity downloaded from the Census Bureau. This is American community survey data for 2010. This column of data here that I'm highlighting contains the census tract ID. This is this column here. It's an identification for the racial or ethnic group. And this column contains the names that are associated with each of these groups. This data here contains the census tract identifier written out. This is the estimate of the total number of people in each of the population groups, and this is the margin of error. In another video, we talked about the large margins of error that come with the American Community Survey data, and so you may not feel comfortable using this data. That's okay. What we're going to do is we're going to just use this as demonstration purposes for the pivot table because it really does demonstrate the value of the pivot table. So to get started, what we're going to do is that I'm going to click on the two over here in the left-hand corner, which highlights the entire row, and I need to be on the home tab, and I'm going to click delete just to get rid of that. But before I do, I want to make sure that I remember what are these column names, because, well, let's go ahead and just do that. Let's call that total and then type in marge error here, and we're going to keep this column and C and A. But because we have two column headers, that presents problems for the management of the data. So generally I just get rid of row two. So click on two and delete. Okay, so now we're ready for the pivot table. As long as this data block is all touching itself, then we can do that. Well, hold on, let's stop, and I want to do something different here. I'm going to sort the data by GOID. You don't have to do this, but I want to make a point here. Let's sort it A to Z, and we'll notice that for this first census tract here in LA County, there are six different classifications, which suggests that census tract isn't particularly diverse. I have pulled one of the more diverse tract IDs out by going through this in ahead of time, and I'm going to just 9202. This, I believe, is one of the more diverse tracts in LA, and if you notice, it has 25 different groups of people. It's important to recognize this, that as we want to manage this data, we have to understand it a little bit first. And so let's just take a look at the Latino category here. These are people who speak or identify as Hispanic. So I'm going to give it a color here, and I will make it a dark gold color here. And there are 4,000 of people in this census tract with this identification. If we go down here to total population, we see that there is a total of 7,000 people in that census tract. And then we need to take a look here and divide people up into any of the other linguistic group, which is not Hispanic. So, and what we will find is that there is not such a listing, that you are either Hispanic, Latino, or you are not. If you are listed here by ethnicity, you will be at least in two categories. So here, this category here, white alone and not Hispanic, would be within total population, but not within this group. But you may also be white and Hispanic if you are white and Hispanic, then you would be in this category. And this number, 741 people, would be listed underneath as part of this category, category 400, as would this category, that category, and anything, some other race alone, Hispanic, Latino. And so this category of Hispanic or Latino includes a lot of other things, including, for example, Mexican. But if this census tract also had Salvadorans or perhaps Cubans or some other group, that would be in there. It is important to distinguish between race, which is smaller, and ethnicity, which in the United States is largely a matter of linguistic identification. But there are many shades on this, so we've got to be careful when we construct our pivot table from this data. So that's what we'll do now. I can scroll back to the top, and I'm going to, as long as my cursor is in this block of data, I can go ahead and click on the Insert tab and select Pivot Table and select OK. And what I want to do is grab GOID, put it here in the rows column, and then I can put it also in the values column. So this gives me a count of the number of times that each of these census tracts appear. So the census tracts with higher numbers are the ones that have the greatest diversity. Then we want to grab this category, pop group title, it's not total, and move it to the columns box. And then it gives us this enormous list of possible ethnic and racial identifications. And we need to narrow that down. So I'm going to click here on this down arrow. I'll expand it so it's easier to see. I'm going to click on select all to unselect everything. I'm going to go to the bottom. And what I want to do is just to select a handful of the most common categories, or the largest categories, or the best known categories. White alone, not Hispanic. So this is white, not Hispanic, is essentially white people. We need definitely total population as well. We would generally want to pick out Black or African American alone, not Hispanic. That's towards the top. Asian alone, or Asian alone, not Hispanic or Latino. So that's generally just Asian people. and then a Hispanic or Latino of any race. Now, you may not like those things that I've chosen, and you can pick others, but to me, these are the sort of largest categories. I'm going to click OK, and now I have the data that I am looking for in general, and I want to grab this pop total and drag it down here to the values box, and I want to switch this from a count to sum, and click OK. And then I'm going to get rid of this count of geodid, just drag it up like that. And so then this, oh, I've made a mistake. It's not that, I want total, the sum of total in here. So this gives me then the total population of the various categories. We can't do a lot with this data in this format while it's still in the pivot table. So I'm going to press Control A, which copies the whole pivot table. Press Control C to copy it, to select it and then copy it. Click on the plus button for a new tab, and then paste as values. And now I can get rid of column one by clicking on the one, not column run, row one, clicking on that, deleting. And now I can expand these. Notice I clicked on A and dragged to G in the column headers, and I can expand these. So I'm just going to call this Asian, this black, this, let's call it Latino, maybe Latinx is more appropriate now, total, white. I'm going to get rid of the grand total column because this actually double counts total and white and Latinx, so we don't want double counting. The last thing I'm going to do is to highlight this entire column, press Control H. I'm going to ask it to find, I'm going to delete everything in the Find What box and replace it with a zero. So any of the census tracts that have a blank will be replaced with a zero. It's a useful trick. Click OK. And that, when I scroll back to the top, is almost what I want. I'm going to do two things here. I'm going to take the column, the total column. This is all the people, regardless of their ethnicity. I'm going to move that over to column G. And in the vacated column E, I'm going to put other as a category. Because as if we sum these just by highlighting and looking down here, that the sum is 4,333, which is shy of this total. So there are people left out, and so this may be people who are black and Hispanic or some other category that is not, that we didn't include. So how do we find the number of other? We have to subtract the total. So that's equal to the total population minus the Asians, the black folks, the Latinos, and the whites. And that would give us, or the difference between the total and who's what's left over. So I just got to copy this all the way down to the rest of the column. And we should have everything we need. We want to, the last step is to copy this and paste it as back as value. And that completes this video tutorial, because we have a nice accounting of ethnicity using a pivot table for Los Angeles County.